Hey YouTube, Jim here. Welcome to Top 10 Archive. You know, we here at the Archive, we know our viewers love a good scare. From scary hospital stories to pictures with creepy backstories, real ghosts caught on tape, all of that is good stuff. So now we're going to bring you the scary stories that are held right in your science book. No flashlights in the dark, no cheap scares behind a bathroom cabinet door. Just real things that are going to happen right here on Mother Earth. Ready to feel doomed? Great. But before we get started, become an archivist today by clicking that subscribe button and notification bell so you don't miss out on any future uploads. If you end up enjoying this video, let us know by giving it a thumbs up. And tell us in the comments section what scary prediction you have for the future.
Number 10, the Sahara Pump Theory. This theory talks about, of course, what's going to happen in the Sahara Desert in the future. How far into the future? Well, let's skip a few pages into the future history of our planet, 15,000 years worth of pages to be exact. This theory says that around that time, the Sahara could possibly look a bit different than it does today. In fact, it could look quite tropical. The precession of the planet's poles could move the North African monsoon all the way there. Now, this brings up a lot of questions for me, but my number one would have to be, where is all the sand going to go? And will this become beachfront property? Number 9. Ross, Destroyer of the Universe. No, it isn't another Marvel movie coming out next year, nor is it a new video game. Ross 248 is a red dwarf star due to pass by our planet in about 37,000 years. At that time, it will be the closest star to the Sun. Now, even though Ross is a red dwarf star and is generally cool as far as stars go, at just under 7,000 degrees Fahrenheit, it's most likely to make some big changes around here. The proximity between the two stars could force a rise in global temperatures and severe weather patterns. But we're still not quite certain of the impact that Ross will bring. Number 8. Niagara Erodes. Yes, the Niagara falls. But the Niagara also gets back up and dusts itself off. Get it? Okay. But more than falling, the Niagara also erodes. In fact, it's been eroding consistently, and talk around the science circles says that the falls will erode Lake Erie almost entirely in about 50,000 years. By then, we'll likely be in another ice age, which, despite being the name of an animated movie, is not as much fun as it sounds. According to scientists Berger and Lutre, the Earth is real close to that next glacial period. Number 7. Star Power. No, this is not a reality TV show where you have a row of sweet and or bitter judges waiting to give a talented young person the chance to make it big. This star power refers to another star, kind of like Ross, who is coming to get us. At least, whatever is left of our planet by the time it makes its way around. This star is Wolf Rayet, also known as WR-104. Is a rare heterogeneous set of stars with unusual spectra showing prominent broad emission lines of ionized helium and highly ionized nitrogen or carbon. What the heck did I just say? In about 300,000 years, it's going to blow into a supernova. Oh, that I understand. Since its discovery, the community has been split on whether or not we'll be fine or if we'll see a catastrophic scenario. But most scientists currently believe that WR-104 posing a risk to be a small one. Number 6. Whose fault is it anyway? So, you know the San Andreas fault, right? It's the one extending through, get this, 1,200 kilometers of California. That's about 750 miles. This fault is the one boundary between tectonic plates, pretty much where one chunk of land meets a different chunk of land. Okay, so maybe Earth is doing all right in 50 million years, but don't get too comfortable. The fault between these plates will cause LA and San Fran to merge, Africa with Eurasia, and create a mountain range resembling the Himalayas. That's going to be a hard crash for anyone involved. The crazy part? It can happen at any time, and many scientists believe we are long overdue for a major event in this area. Number 5. Hot and bright. Imagine a hot summer day when not only is the sweat real, but you also can't shield your eyes from the sun, even with your expensive sunglasses. If you hate the thought of these kinds of days, you're not going to like the news I'm bringing. In 1 billion years, the average temperature on Earth is going to be a boiling 116 degrees Fahrenheit. Not because of global warming, but because the sun is going to be 10% brighter. Imagine what would happen if it were more than 10%. You know how Silicon Valley is working on that whole not dying thing? I'm going to pass when that investment opportunity comes knocking on my door. The future is looking a little too bright. Number 4. The floor is lava. Let's say you somehow survive the crazy hot temperatures, the tectonic faults, and all the rest of the things we're warning you about now. What if the internet trend that went viral in recent years, the floor is lava, actually turned into prophecy? There's a theory out there saying that in 7 billion years or so, the Earth will no longer be the beautiful green and blue planet that we are accustomed to. It's going to be covered in an ocean of lava. That's not the end of it either. This is going to be right before the sun turns into a red giant and we all get sucked into it. Number 3. Tide locked. Going even further, let's talk about what will happen in 50 billion years, if the moon and the Earth survive, that is. It's said that at that time, the moon and the Earth will become tide locked, meaning that the gravity will be holding them together so tight that they'll only be showing each other one face. That not only means that only half the Earth gets to catch a glimpse of the moon, but also that the lunar orbit will decay, the Earth's spin will accelerate, and, well, who even knows what will happen to us all after that. Number 2. The Big Rip. Now, there are a lot of fart jokes I could make with this one, but instead, I'm going to be an adult and tell you what this is really about. Okay, seriously. This is life or death, people. Mostly death. Here's a timeline of the Big Rip. 200 million years before the event itself, galaxy clusters are destroyed. 60 million years before, all galaxies lose their stars and disintegrate, and right before, like months before, star systems lose gravity and planets fly into the universe. Minutes before, everything evaporates into atoms, and then even space and time disintegrates. Number 1. The Big Crunch. Big bangs, big rips, and now big crunches? You can't do things small in the universe. When I first read this, I got excited because crunch bars are my favorite. However, this is not a big chocolate bar, not by a long shot. The Big Crunch says that we're going to be so close together with other things in the universe that we'll be colliding, exploding, and creating all this crazy kinetic energy. Temperatures will rise to 180,000 degrees, which not even the stars will be able to handle, slowly cooking themselves to death. As if that weren't weird, disgusting, and scary enough, the closeness will make all the black holes merge into one massive black hole, devouring itself. Epic. Thanks for watching. You may not be around for most of these possible and scary events, but stick around right now to leave your comments below about this video, and to subscribe, click the bell, and give this video a like. Nothing scary about that.